Hello everyone, today we are discussing the topic called ADC. So already we are discussing the introduction to ADC and what are the some characteristics of ADC, that is resolution. So before that, work hard, dream big, never give up. So with this positive quote I will start my lecture. Dual slope ADC is the integrating type ADC, means it uses the integrator circuit for the conversion. So dual slope ADC converts the analog signal into the digital signal. So in order to convert the analog signal into the digital signal, for dual slope ADC it uses the integrator circuit. And these type of ADC provides high resolution with good accuracy, and it is having the slow conversion time. So due to this, it is not used in the signal processing application where a lot of data needs to be acquired continuously. So dual slope ADC uses the integrating type. Dual slope ADC is also called as the integrating type ADC because it uses the integrated circuit for the conversion, and it is having the high resolution. What is resolution? Resolution is nothing but if you are made changes in the input voltage, according to that the output voltage is also affected. So the resolution is given by the formula VR by 2 power N, where VR is the reference voltages. So here it is having high resolution and good accuracy, and it is having the slow conversion time. So due to this, it is not used in the signal processing where the data, a lot of data needs to be acquired continuously, and it is having the high resolution. So due to that, it is commonly used for the measuring instruments. Mostly it is used in the digital multimeters. So before the dual slope ADC, we need to study about the single slope ADC. So in single slope ADC we are having the circuit called integrator and comparator. So here integrator circuit is the device which will integrate the input voltage, and here we are giving some input voltage minus V reference, and that is integrated by the circuit integrator. So this integrated voltage will be compared with the input voltage, and according to that the comparator will give the either logic 1 or logic low as its output. So here minus V reference is connected to the input for the integrator circuit, and here V naught is nothing but integration of the input voltage, that is given by minus 1 by RC integral of minus V reference into dt. So here this negative sign is due to because here the input is connected to the inverting terminal, that's why here it is having some negative sign, and the input voltage is the minus V reference into dt. So here the integrator circuit integrates the input voltage, and that integrated voltage is given as the V naught, and V naught is compared with the V in. So if V naught is very less, that is the inverting terminal voltage is very less when compared to the input voltage, then the output of the comparator is high. If V naught is very high when compared to the input voltage, then the output of the comparator is low. So single slope ADC is having integrator and comparator. So integrator output is minus 1 by RC integral of minus V reference into RT. So here the reference voltage, that is V reference, is integrated until the reference voltage is equal to the Vin. So whenever the V naught becomes Vin, then the comparator output will become low. So up to that the integrator is integrating the reference voltage. So the reference voltage is integrated until the output voltage is equal to the input voltage, that is V naught is equal to the Vn. So once V naught is equal to Vn, so after that the integrator stops its working. So let us say the time required for the integrator to integrate the voltage, reference voltage, up to V naught equal to Vn. So let us say the time t is required by the integrator. So at the time t, the V naught equal to Vn. That is nothing but at the time t, the V naught equal to Vn. So here V naught equal to minus 1 by RC means here the output of the integrator is V naught, that is given by minus 1 by RC integral of minus V reference into D2. Minus and minus gets cancelled out, that is 1 by RC integral of V reference into RT. Here I am saying that at time t, at time t the v naught becomes vn. So here the integral limits are taken as 0 to t. So if you substitute the integral limits, that is at time t the output voltage equal to the input voltage, that is v naught equal to t into v reference by rc, that is equal to v naught. At time t the v naught becomes vn. So vn becomes t into v reference by rc. So here v reference value is the constant and r and c values are so constant. So these two are constant, v reference and r and c values constant. So the vn is directly proportional to the time. So depending on the time, the vn value also changes. The vn value is directly proportional to the time. So this is the single slope ADC. So here I am having the integrator. This integrator integrates the V reference voltage, and according to that the integrated voltage will be appeared at the inverting terminal of the comparator. And these two voltages, the inverting and non-inverting voltages, here the non-inverting terminal we are applying the Vin, are compared, and according to that the comparator output will be logic high or zero, and that logic high or logic low signal will be applied to the AND gate, and according to that the counter starts it working. So let us say I am applying some V reference voltage and I am getting the integrated output voltage here, some V naught, and that voltage will be lesser than the Vin. So in that case the comparator output will be logic high. So the clock pulse is also applied and the AND gate output will be high. So the counter starts its working and it will give the output as binary output. So here I am applying the analog signal and I am getting the binary output. So in this way the single slope ADC works. So the output of the comparator is given to the AND gate, the output of the comparator is given to the AND gate. So whenever the output of the comparator is high, then the clock pulses will be applied. As soon as this counter gets clock pulses, it starts counting. So whenever V naught is less than Vin, so V naught is the integrator output. So whenever V naught is less than Vin, then the counter starts working. So this V naught value is directly proportional to the input voltage. This counting is directly proportional to the Vin value. So in this way the single slope ADC converts the input voltage into the binary output. So here this is the single slope ADC reference voltage versus Vin diagram. So here the reference voltage V reference by RC. This is the single slope ADC. Here the slope is the slope value of the integrator. So here we are using the integrator. The slope of the integrator depends on the values of V reference by RC. So V reference by RC. Here V reference and R and C values are fixed. So the Vin is directly proportional to the time. And R and C values are fixed, but sometime, for example, if we take the example, Vn equal to 2 volts, according to that, at time t1 we are getting this slope t1 equal to 2 milliseconds. So for the same input voltage Vn equal to 2 volts. Sometimes we are getting the time period as 3 milliseconds. This is due to the changes in the R and C values. So for Vn equal to 2 volts, I need to get the time is 2 milliseconds. But for same input voltage, sometimes I will get the time period as 3 milliseconds. But here the formula indicates Vn is directly proportional to the time. So Vn equal to 2 volts, I need to get 2 milliseconds as the time period. But here Vn equal to 2 volts, sometimes I am getting the time period as 3 milliseconds. This is due to the changes in the values of R and C. So this is the disadvantage of the single slope ADC. In order to avoid that, or in order to overcome the disadvantage, we are going for the dual slope ADC. So accuracy of the single slope ADC is very poor. That is the reason we are not using this ADC for measurement purpose. But this problem can be solved by using the dual slope ADC. So here in dual slope ADC, this is similar to single slope ADC, only the difference is here we are having the two voltages. So the integrator can switch to connected to either Vin or V reference. So initially I am saying that the integrator input is connected to the Vin. So whenever it is connected to Vin, the output of the integrator is integral of V naught. So V naught equal to minus 1 by RC integral of Vin into dt. And that voltage is given to the inverting terminal of the comparator. This is the comparator. So inverting terminal of the comparator is comparator. So depending on this inverting voltage and non-inverting voltage, we are getting some logic high or logic low at the output of the comparator, and that will be given to the clock, that will be given to the AND gate, and depending on that the counter starts working. So let us say first, in case of dual slope ADC, there is a switch at the input of the integrator which can connect either to the input voltage Vin or to the reference voltage VR. So initially during the start of conversion, let us say the switch is connected to the Vin. So this switch is connected to the Vin. So whenever the switch is connected to the Vin, so we are getting the integrated voltage, the V naught equal to minus 1 by RC integral of Vin into dt. So at time t1, after some time t1, we are getting V naught value is, that means we are substituting the limits 0 to t1. So at the time we are getting the output voltage is minus t1 by RC into Vin. So after some time t1, the integrator will connect it to the minus V reference. So initially it is connected to the Vin. So we are getting the V naught value is minus 1 by RC integral of Vin into dt. So it will connect up to time t1. So after some time t1, this is connected to the minus V reference. So when this is connected to the minus V reference, so V naught becomes minus 1 by RC integral of minus V reference into dt, and minus and minus gets cancelled, that is equal to 1 by RC integral of V reference into dt. So then that time the output voltage V naught is given by T2 by RC into V reference. So first of all it is connected to the Vin, after that it is connected to the minus V reference. So if it is connected to the Vin, we are getting the negative sign, that's why here we are having the negative slope. Whenever it is connected to the minus V reference, minus into minus cancelled out, so here we are getting the V reference by RC. This V reference by RC indicates the slope, so this is having the positive slope, so that's why here we are having the positive slope. So up to time t1 it is connected to the Vin. So whenever it is connected to the Vin, the integrator output is minus t1 by RC into Vin. So here the negative slope is minus Vin by RC. Whenever it is connected to the V reference, minus into minus gets cancelled out. So here the slope is V reference by RC. This is the positive slope. So here in the first case, let us say that if it is connected to the Vin, then the output of the integrator is minus 1 by RC integral of Vin into dt. So this value is some negative value. So that is nothing but the non-inverting terminal is connected to ground. That is nothing but the negative value is lesser than the zero. So the output of the comparator is high. So this will be connected to the AND gate. So the counter starts counting. So it will be we are getting the digital output according to the voltage applied at the input. And if for example this is the 4-bit counter, it will count up to 0, it will count from 000 to 111. So after 111 it is connected to the minus V reference voltage. Minus V reference voltage means we are getting the some positive voltage. If it is connected to minus V reference voltage, the output of the integrator becomes 1 by RC integral of minus V reference into dt. Minus minus gets cancelled out, so we are getting the positive voltage. So the positive voltage is definitely greater than the zero voltage. So the output of the comparator will be zero, because here we are having some positive voltage. At the inverting terminal we are having the positive voltage, at the non-inverting terminal we are having the zero volts. So inverting terminal voltage is greater than the non-inverting terminal voltage. That's the reason the output of the comparator is low, and this zero will be connected to the clock and the counter gets reset. So in this way the dual slope ADC works, and this process continues up to these inverting terminal voltage is zero. So once the inverting terminal voltage is zero, again we are having the output of the comparator is zero and that will be connected. So this process continues. So initially it is connected to VN. So after some time T1, that means if it is the 4 bit counter, it will count from 000 to 1111. So after the count, particular count, it will connect it to the minus V reference. So whenever it is connected to the minus V reference, the output of the integrated becomes minus 1 by RC integral of minus V reference into dt. That means some positive voltage. So the inverting terminal voltage is higher and the comparator output is low. So according to that, the count will happen. So in this way, the dual slope integrator works. The dual slope ADC work. So here, the output voltage is the combination of two. That is, first the switch is connected to VN, and second time the switch is connected to the V reference. Whenever the switch is connected to VN, the output voltage is minus T1 by RC into VN. Whenever the switch is connected to the V reference, the output voltage is T2 by RC into V reference. So I am equating these two voltages, because these two voltages are equal. One is converting from this point to this point. So this time and this time are equal. That means this voltage and these two voltages are equal. One is getting from zero to the maximum count, and another is from the maximum to the zero value. So here I am getting the negative slope, because here the time constant is, here the slope is minus VN by RC whenever the switch is connected to the VN. And here I am getting the positive slope, because here the switch is connected to the minus V reference. That's the reason minus into minus becomes the plus. So here the slope becomes V reference by RC. So here I am equating the two times. So T2 becomes T1 VN by V reference. So the T2 time is directly proportional to the VN. So here we need to calculate the conversion time. So the time taken for converting this voltage to the digital voltage is given by the 2 power n clock cycles, and the time taken for this voltage to the digital voltage is given by the n clock cycles. So the total time taken by the converter, is given by 2 power n clock cycle. So whenever the switch is connected to the VN and whenever the switch is connected to the minus V reference, it will take n clock cycles. That is 2 power n clock cycles into n clock cycles. And this n clock cycles, let us say the n value is 2. So 2 power n, and here in place of n I am substituting 2. So 2 into 2 power n into clock cycle, that is equal to 2 power n plus 1 clock cycles. This formula is very important. The conversion time of dual slope ADC is 2 power n plus 1 clock cycles. So one example, if we are taking the 12 bit dual slope ADC and I am saying that the clock frequency is 10 megahertz, so what is the conversion time? So just substitute the values in the formula, that is 2 power n plus 1 into TC. So we are getting the 0.8 milliseconds. So do the homework problem. That is, if you are taking the 10 bit dual slope ADC and the clock frequency is 6 megahertz, so what is the conversion time? So thank you all. Hope you understood what is single slope ADC and what is dual slope ADC, and how you are you are converting the particular analog signal into the digital signal. Thank you all.